Fit of TV.
I am going to even use the opportunity to go a little bit further to talk about Emosina. When you're going to be a man, as one of us here, Emosina is not tough for me when it's a tough one.
Plenty!
You were gift, ebony, now or you're gifted. And you were anointed. You can be gifted and anointed at the same time.
Somebody
can have a gift and somebody can have an anointing.
Se woni pedin se wuno na wote Awurade asem so atia,
they can lose the anointing, but the gifts of God are without repentance.
Therefore,
in Iba bebrebe wo Ghana had, they've lost anointing.
They started
very well,
they were great
in the eyes of the Lord,
but gift
is now what is remaining. When it is gift that is remaining, oh, then there are so many gifted people. Too many gifted people. And the Bible said, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of our time, strength of knowledge, and the fear of God will be a treasure in my generation. Isaiah 33:6. It's when you lose the anointing, forget it. You can't do this, because without anointing, you can't work for God. And Jesus said, tarry here in Jerusalem until you will be endued. I'm telling you, the anointing. Gospel musicians, look at the way the move of God is shifting from Ghanaian gospel musicians to Nigerian gospel musicians. Now in our churches, when you come to worship, most of the songs we sing unto God are all Nigerian, composed by our brothers and sisters who are Nigerians. Are our people. You will be like Samson.
The presence
of God will be gone, and you will be saying things like, I will go out as before and shake myself. But what you don't know is that that power, that spirit, that ovation, that euphoria, that force, that presence that was on you is already gone. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to this young men and women, this upcoming emergent generation, this invigorated breed of people. Let me let you understand. Look at how you tarried and wait and prepared. You know, in the presence of the Lord, in prayer comes, in places of prayer, in retreat centers, waiting on the Lord to drop an anointing on you. And then the moment you get it, you forget about the process and you want to just use it anyhow. You think the anointing is an industry, you think the anointing is a merchandise, you think the anointing is for sale, you think the anointing is some kind of ATM. Do you think the anointing is to amass wealth and enrich yourself? The Bible said, freely you have received and freely give. For in the last days I will pour my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and daughters will prophesy, and upon the old men and old women, they will receive the power to dream dreams. The assembly, but I may cast them at your Jesus.